day, everyone. So my name is Kristine Ricardo from 11 News McKenzie. So today's video, I'm going to discuss about the introduction of social science. Before that, I'm going to show you a video clip about the introduction of social science and their major branches.
They came up with the idea that became the National Health Service. They shaped the growth of the welfare state, providing a safety net for those needing a helping hand. And they helped the Bank of England deal with the financial crisis. Who are these people? The ones behind some of the most important changes to Britain in the last century. Social scientists, that's who. Their research covers the full span of human behaviour, from economics to education, sociology, geography, linguistics and social anthropology, psychology to social work and even business and management studies. They look at how society works, how we react and adapt to changes, why some things succeed and others don't. Social scientists do their research in different ways. Sometimes they set out to prove or disprove something in particular. Other times they come across new and unexpected findings when doing basic research. The Economic and Social Research Council is the UK's largest funder of social science research. And to ensure the research we fund is of high quality, all research applications undergo peer review. That is, they are quality checked by other experts and social scientists, which means the research questions, design and findings will be of the highest standards and quality. This ensures the findings are reliable and usable. Science research uses large-scale research projects. These follow groups of people through their lives over many years. The results can help all of us, including government, ministers, and even businesses and charities, understand how society changes and the impact this can have on individual lives. This long-term work has helped us discover the effect smoking during pregnancy has on the development of children, identify the scarring effects repeated unemployment and poverty can have, and what impact living in a lone parent family can have on a child's future. The social sciences are all about understanding the way humans behave and interact with each other, helping to make our society a better place to live.
Let's proceed to our main topic, which is the introduction of social science and their major branches. So what is social science? Social science is a branch of science that deals with the institution and functioning of human society and with the interpersonal relationship of individuals as members of society. So si social science daw ang function niya, siya ay isang uri ng pag-aaral na kung saan nakakatulong upang magkaroon ng maayos na ugnayan o relasyon ang bawat individual sa isang lipunan. Social science is being divided into a lot of branches. There are various branches of social science which are universally accepted in the educational organizations as signified disciplines of studies. Every branch of social science deals with the particular areas of human and social knowledge. So it means si social science ay nahati sa ilang branch o sangay. The first branch of social science is anthropology. Anthropology or science humanity, this is branch of social science which deals with the study of ancient stories and extracts which determine the human origin, civilization, culture, and development. So, si anthropology daw or anthropologiya o tinatawag ding science humanity, ang function niya, ito ay pagsusuri o pag-aaral patungkol sa tao, sa tulad ng evolusyon ng tao, hayop, at iba pa. So next is economics. Economics is directly related to the current condition of the world where the necessary context deals with the creation, production, distribution, and monetization of wealth. By wealth, it does not refer to money. These are essential products or resources which has a high demand supply market in the society. So it means economics daw, siya yung may responsibilidad o pag-aaral na kung saan may responsibilidad sa kondisyon, kalagayan ng ating bansa. So dahil sa economics din, dito din inaalam kung gaano yung demand o supply na kailangan ng tao. Third is political science. Political science is the branch of social science which deals with the study of all the current socio-political aspects like government policies, administration, democracy, and administrative management is called political science. So it means si political science daw, from the word political, ito ay pag-aaral o pagsusuri na patungkol sa political na aspekto tulad ng administrasyon, polisiya, at iba pa. Branch is sociology. Sociology is the detailed study of varied human cultures, traditions, social status, and beliefs in various social institutions or organizations. It deals with every aspect of human society. So, si social naman ay siya yung nag-aaral patungkol sa tradisyon, cultures, paniniwala ng bawat tao sa isang lipunan. Ecology, this is perhaps the most scientific branch of social science. Psychology deals with the various abstract entities which constitute the overall mind and thought process of human being, the way they behave, think, believe, perceive, or internalize things and reflect that on the society. So it means, si psychology daw, ito ay pag-aaral o pagsusuri patungkol sa kung paano kumilos yung tao, kung paano mag-isip o maging yung pananaw ng tao, yun yung ginagawa or pagsusuri na ginagawa ni psychology. Then next is archaeology. Archaeology also deals with ancient studies of human beings where the prime focus is on the objects or things made, used or left behind by the people at various situations of the past. So si archaeology daw naman, konektado sila ni anthropology. Ngunit si archaeology, ito yung pag-aaral o pagsusuri na kung saan yung inaaral nila is yung mga lumang kagamitan tulad ng artifacts. Ngunit sa anthropology, ang ginagawa naman o sinusuri is yung pag-aaral patungkol sa tao, samantalang sa archaeology, sa kagamitan. So, next branch is law. So, law is related to the legislation and judicial system of the country. This branch of social science deals with the study of all the sets of rules or regulations which are collectively made by the constitution or the government for the maintenance of order and legalization in the society. So, ibig sabihin, si law, siya yung tumutulong upang magkaroon ng maayos na alintuntunin o batas para na rin sa kaayusan ng bawat tao sa isang lipunan. Last branch is geography. Geography is again a very particular and scientific branch of social science, which deals with the study of the physical and psychological features, mountain, rivers, trees, plains, desert, oceans, and etc. of the earth. So, si geography daw, o geografiya, ay nagmula sa salitang Griego na ang ibig sabihin ng geo o lupain, at graphia na ibig sabihin naman ay paglalarawan. Ang geografiya ang siyang nag-aaral patungkol sa lokasyon, lupain tulad ng bundok, burol, at mga katubigan. So, ayun si geography. Thank you.